Hello and welcome to Weekly Financial Modeling Tips by the Startup Station. Today we're going to learn how to model a viral effect in marketing. What we want to determine here is the expected number of customers from a digital marketing strategy incorporating word of mouth. So we need to do assumptions both for the digital marketing strategy as well as the word of mouth effect. So for the digital marketing strategy, we need to figure out what your overall marketing budget is and how much of it is allocated towards the strategy in years 1 to 5. And you want to account for seasonality, right? In a way that whether you distribute that budget evenly throughout the year or whether this distribution varies based on each month. Then you want to think about the customer acquisition cost, and this is where the word of mouth effect will come in. So first you want to estimate the cost without the word of mouth. Then you want to think about when the word of mouth effect will start and how your customer acquisition cost will change with this effect. So for example, will it reduce by 10%, 15%, 7%, etc.? How do you do that? Initially, you want to use a industry norm. We've talked about this concept before. If you don't have any data, you want to use an average per channel. Similarly, you can do research on how those costs or those conversion rates improve with the word of mouth effect and use an average of those estimates for your own word of mouth estimate before you get any data. Now, in terms of when the word of mouth effect can start, it can again be discretionary. It can be 6 months or 1 year or whenever you think is reasonable. There is no rule for that either. So let's see how we're going to get this done. We see here our assumptions in blue. The user acquisition cost is $20. Word of mouth improvement is 20%, starts in month 7 on a $1 million budget. Here is the digital marketing budget allocation throughout the year. And we're also assuming a certain average purchase amount. So let's begin by calculating our monthly digital marketing budget by multiplying the allocation times the annual budget. We're going to anchor it so that we can piece this formula along using the F4 function. Okay, the next step is to calculate the user acquisition cost and incorporate the word of mouth. So for the first 6 months, it's going to be simply $20. Again, we're going to anchor it so we can paste the formula along. And in month 7, it's going to be $20 reduced by 20%. Right? And again, we're going to anchor both variables so that we can paste this along. Okay, so then we need to calculate the number of new customers. We're going to use the floor function to avoid any partial results. And then we're going to divide our marketing budget by the user acquisition cost. Okay, and get the total number of new customers. The final step is to calculate revenues. So we're going to take the average purchase amount and multiply it by the number of customers and take this along. And so we see that we've made 1.35 million. Again, this is a sign that potentially either this user acquisition cost is too high or the purchase amount is too low, because of course, this is not a profitable business, right? We've seen a similar result when we modeled the social media strategy.
So this is it. Thank you for watching. Please comment below if you like this video, share with your friends and other founders. Sign up for this YouTube channel to get more weekly financial modeling tips every Tuesday. And if you want to learn our unique framework for modeling early stage ventures, sign up for our masterclass. The link is in the description. Thanks again, and I'll see you next week. Bye.